Good morning, students. Today, year 1.5, his first flight, third passage we discuss. Look at the third passage. The passage starts from ga ga ga, dash dash dash, soaring and diving. Remember. Let us see. I read out the passage. You listen carefully. Ga ga ga, he cried, begging her bring him some food. Ga call ah, she screamed back derisively, but he kept calling plaintively, and after a minute or so he uttered a joyful scream. Now here in the third passage again, mother is trying her attempt. Means she was showing off a morsel of food as a fish. So looking at fish, somehow he takes his flight. So that was mother's attempt. And after a minute or so, he uttered a joyful scream. So one side mother was screaming, showing that kind of food. And other side here, that little seagull bird also was crying. Looking at mother, he was showing his love and sympathy and wants food from mother. His mother had picked up a piece of fish and was flying across to him with it. Mother, in her beak, showing off that fish, and she was flying around. So somehow he can do it. He leaned out eagerly, tapping the rock with his feet, trying to get nearer to her as she flew across. At the beginning, mother showed such kind of small fish in her beak, then reached the nearer, the nearest, and again take fly away. So mother was attempting in her own way, but when she was just opposite to him, she halted, her wings motionless, the piece of fish in her beak almost within reach of his beak. Means what do you understand? We understand here the mother was trying to take his first flight, and for that she shows her fish in her beak. She goes near and then goes far away. So somehow here little seagull bird can catch the fish, and in catching somehow he has to fall into the water, and so he can open his wings and can fly. So that was the attempt of her mother. Now, particular within his reach of his beak, he waited a moment in surprise, wondering why she did not come nearer, and then, maddened by hunger, he dived at the fish. Mother attempted one round, second round, third round, fourth round. So number of rounds are there, but she could not give a small piece of fish. So the little seagull bird was so hungry from the last night, last day. Here he is hungry and he wants food. So this time he decided, now I catch the fish, and he dived particular on that piece of fish. With a loud scream off, he fell outwards and downwards into space. When he falls down, catching the fish, he could not fall downside because he had wings. And with the help of wings, sometimes he goes downside, sometimes he goes upward. So first time here, the little seagull bird understand the value of its own wings, and first time he understand his wings are supporting him and the strength boost his confidence and courage and feels very happy first time. So then he monstrous terror seized him and his heart stood still. He could hear nothing, but it only lasted a minute. The next minute he felt his wings spread outwards. So in this passage we understand when he jumps downside, he feels that I am gone. My last moments I have to count, but happens different. And he observe his wings are spread and his wings are moving and he is flying in the sky. And first time he feels very relaxed and happy looking at his feathers. The wind rushed against his breast feathers, then under his stomach and against his wings. He could feel the tip of his wings cutting through the air. So first attempt, here wings, the wind and the wind way, and how does he fly, his legs and his body, that balance in the air. So everything, it was a first. And first experience here teaches him that you can fly if you think you can. He was not falling headlong now. He was soaring gradually downwards and outwards. Now he has confidence and courage, and with the help of wings now he is able to soar in the sky. First time he feels, and when you feel it, definitely experience is the best teacher. So it was the first experience. He was no longer afraid. He just felt a bit dizzy. Then he flapped his wings once and he soared upwards. Now he concentrate himself and flipped his wings, and then again takes a long soar, fly very high in the sky. Ga ga, it's the pronunciation of the bird. Ga ga ga, ga ga. His mother swooped past him, her wings making a loud noise. So when he was using sound that I can fly, look, so mother also become happy, father also become happy, brother and sister also become happy, and they were also crying loudly. Here mother was crying loudly in a loud voice. He answered her with another scream. Then his father flew over him screaming. Then father also understand here his son has taken first flight and he feels very proud of. He saw his two brothers and his sisters flying around his curvetting and banking and soaring and dive. So family members, brothers, two brothers and one sister, they also congratulating him that at last you have taken your first flight, and that's the spirit. All the best, everyone was saying, not in like our human being language, but in their bird's language. Actually language, do you know, animal, bird, they have also language. We don't understand, that's problem. So, but we understand their feelings. So everyone congratulating him for his first time. So here in the third passage we understand, in the third attempt here mother could got success. Actually little seagull bird got success, but here mother got success. Why? Because mother attempted first time, second time, third time, number of tricks she has used to learn the skills, and he was unable to follow. But last mother played very careful trick. That trick enabled or compelled him to jump downside, and when he jumps down he learns to fly in the sky. Okay, in the third passage let us see new words. I read out. First word is monstrous. Monstrous means here shocking, breaking. Second, dizzy. Dizzy means here uncomfortable, feeling uncomfortable or that is become you become unconscious also. Curvating means leaping or jumping like a horse. Banking means here flying with one wing higher than the other, that is banking. Next, derisively, in a manner showing someone that he or she is stupid, means showing off as a stupid. And last, plaintively. Plaintively means here expressing sorrow. So these new words we have to remember to comprehend the content of this passage. Now, for the third passage, again we have the same format, A1, A2, A3. Let us discuss about A4, grammar. In grammar section, we have two examples I like to tell you. Number one, he could feel the tips of his wings cutting through the air. And in bracket, use able to. So when we use able to, only able to word is not used beside the main verb, replacing helping verb. We have to use to be form. If the given sentence present form, use am is are plus able to. If the given sentence past tense form, use was were plus able to. So what is the answer? He was able to feel the tips of his wings cutting through the air. So that way we have to remember new rule. Next, he uttered a joyful scream. In bracket, make it exclamatory. So look at the sentence, and sentence begins with how or what. After verb, if you find only adjective, only adverb and complement, use how. And after verb, if you find article, adjective, noun, we have to start sentence what a or what an according to that word. So answer is, what a joyful scream he uttered, and put exclamatory mark, remember. And last question is that A5, personal response. Young birds are afraid to make their first flight because, now whenever here young ones take first flight, the first flight of exam or life, any problem, difficulties or any kind of first time, so they are afraid of. Why do they afraid? Because here, because you have to write your own opinion. So it is their first flight. Definitely they have first flight. They don't have knowledge and skill. First means no knowledge, no idea, no skill. They don't have confidence. They did not apply their confidence. That's why they don't know the confidence. They don't do daring. For daring, we must have problem and difficulty. And not take any risk. So risk point is not taken in her life. And that's why they don't take risk. So these reasons we have to practice in our writing. So this is about the passage number third. Here, third passage is completed. Let us see fourth passage. Thank you.